Got it? Got a good look? Ready for some good guesses? Okay, we'll draw a price. Now I need to ask you something. How many of you play tennis? Raise your hand. Put your hand down. How many of you know who Serena Williams is? Raise your hand. Oh my gosh, you have to play this. Last night I helped wrap some of the baskets for the gala. She is like way, way famous. That is such a good item to get on.
Number one in the world.
If, what? I'm sorry, say it again.
She is number one in the world.
Can you believe that? And we have an opportunity. It's going to be at our table. I couldn't believe when I saw that. I had to handle it very carefully so I wouldn't get it dirty or anything. So. And also, I'm trying to think of some other things I saw. Tiffany earrings and a Tiffany bracelet. I saw there were items, lots of nice, nice jewelry that your parents could bid on, and games for you, parties for you. We are having a very special Freaky Friday day. Who saw the movie Freaky Friday? Who saw that? What happened to Freaky Friday, Natalie? The child trades place with the adult. They just became each other. That's going to happen on Hub Campus. April 26th, Freaky Friday, and your parents get to bid for you to participate. So you get to become a teacher, the teachers become you. Is that kind of freaky or what?
Yes.
As Mrs. Hurst is telling you all about all these fun parties and things we're going to have, this year we're introducing mobile bidding, which is going to mean that your parents get to have something that looks like an iTouch, and they get to make all their bids on everything with that device, or their own phone, they can download an app. So with that comes a website that most of them have seen so far, that they get to, they've been buying their tickets on and looking at. But next week, we're going to start previewing these parties. So you can sit down with your mom and dad for some of these parties and say, hey, this is what I want to do, or I want to do the library sleepover. So they'll get to read about a lot of these things, not everything, but most of them next week. So the week going into gala, you'll get to sit down with your parents and tell them what you really want to do.
Thank you. We are looking forward to that. And now I have a special presentation. It is time for the Panera Bread Student of the Month, and I want to read you a little bit about this student. This student is always positive, always, always in the classroom with a positive attitude, enthusiastic, always helpful with friends, not only in the classroom, but also on the playground. This person always has a constant smile. Always kind, always helpful. Can I have a drum roll, please? And this award for Student of the Month goes to Ted Belkowski. And Ted, you saw it here. You have a fun time at the Bread, and we are very proud of you. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
He read that poem. I mean, he's never even seen this poem before. This is a book, Feathers, Poems About Birds. Because you don't just write prose, you write poetry also, right? And this book is given to the Canterbury School Library for gratitude to Almighty God in honor of Jack, Love, Mom, Dad, and Alex. Happy, happy birthday. When is your actual birthday?
11.
And how old will you be?
11.
11 years old in July. All right. And this book is given to the Canterbury School Library for gratitude to Almighty God and in honor of Jack from your little buddy Henry, February 20th, 2013. And this book is called The Obstinate Hen, and I had to grab it out of this awesome author's hand today because I think she's going to like it also. So let's have a birthday song from Jack.
Related, how they are related in any way. Stephen? They're all living, that's good. Mia?
They're all animals, that's right.
Have you ever been sick and had to stay home? You've been homesick? Who are you?
My name is Vicky.
Do you have a job?
Yes, I have the best job in the world.
And what is your job?
I work at the zoo.
And what do you do at the zoo?
Well, I think you need to read my stuff to find out the answer to all these questions. Thank you, Scotty. Thank you for having me.
So she's not going to give the answer away. She's going to have, you're going to have to wait until you read the book, A Sick Day for Amos McGee. And I have several copies up here. I'll give it to your teacher after you finish reading it, if you pass it on to someone who doesn't have it. And also I want to introduce the community service for the month. Not sure if you're familiar with Zoe's Edible Garden, but it is a garden that was a gift from mother and father, Tyson and Summer Grant. Tyson is the executive chef down at Park Shore Grill. Or no, he's a partner at Park Shore Grill. And his wife is a nurse at Bayfront. They had a little girl that was born in 2009, and she only lived for a year. She only lived for a month, and then she passed away from complications. And they wanted a way to remember her and to honor her, and they built a garden down at All Children's Hospital. And the children that are staying in the hospital get to visit the garden. They get to harvest food that they actually get to eat. So today, Mrs. Howie's going to send an e-notify out to everyone that has a wish list on it for the things that we are going to collect for Zoe's Edible Garden, and also for some of the patients down at All Children's Hospital. And then on March the 7th, we get to actually go down and meet Tyson at the garden, and he's going to let us work in the garden, and we're going to get to bring all of our donations to the garden. So I thought that went well with Karen and Sympathy, and since it's a children's garden and we're kindergarten, I thought it all made sense. So there'll be a bucket outside, or a big basket outside my room, if you can put your donations in there. We will deliver them on the 7th of March. And why the owls are reading. All right,
okay, so get ready to enjoy that book in your classroom. That'll be exciting for us to find out how the story goes. All right, so we all have to stand up so we can see our